Hey YouTube, what's up? Thought I'd make a quick little video tonight. While I was watching TV, I was inspired to make a video about some of my favorite shows on television, specifically paranormal shows. I don't know about you guys, but I really like paranormal shows. Specifically, some of the ones I like are Paranormal Activity. That's a movie. But I'm going to leave that in. I'm not going to edit it out because, you know, I make mistakes. Paranormal State. I was just watching Paranormal State. And I really like that show. Although I have to say that this current season, which is almost over, I think the season finale is next week, it just isn't as good as the previous seasons, in my opinion. I think, you know, in the previous seasons, they focused more on helping families. You know, they go in there and, you know, they do house cleansings and they perform exorcisms and they do, you know, crazy stuff, you know, and I thought all that was cool. And now they seem to be, they still go to families' homes and they investigate, but it seems like they just stop at the investigation. And they don't, you know, they seem to just really, really rush through what they do to help them. You know, there and the end of Paranormal State, there's always a couple sentences recap, you know, at the end that say, you know, like, their activity has stopped has decreased significantly since they, you know, demanded to have their house back from the spirits and blah, 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 whatever. But I do miss, I kind of miss that stuff where they actively did things in the houses to help them. But I don't know, we'll see, maybe, I don't know if it's coming back for another season, but if it does, I hope they bring it back to more stuff like that. The next show is Ghost Hunters. I like Ghost Hunters, and I'm not gonna lie, one of the main reasons is Steve Gonzalez, because I have like a major crush on him, because he's super cute and tattooed and all cuddly and bear-like. What can I say? That one is just straight up investigation. They don't do anything. Like, their purpose is to find evidence, which is cool. I like that one. One show that I don't like is Ghost Adventures on the Travel Channel. You know, the first time I saw that, I'm like, ooh, another show that I haven't seen. I clicked on it and I started watching it and I just, oh my god, I can't stand it. Like, the main dude, I just want to smack him in the face. Like, he just, for some reason, and maybe it's just me, but I've heard other people agree with me on this one, is the main guy just screams douchebag. He just does. The way he dresses, his hair, the way he, you know, talks to the ghosts, you know, and douchebag. He screams douchebag. So I don't even watch that show. And I like to watch paranormal shows. That one, I don't watch. Factor Faked, Paranormal Files. I like that show. They just finished their second season. Really short second season, but it was still, it's cool, you know, they have a case and they try to, they don't just investigate, but they try to, you know, like, debunk it by trying to duplicate, you know, the footage to see, like, oh yeah, we were totally able to duplicate the footage, like, this is how you do it, blah, blah. Or, you know, sometimes they just, like, we couldn't duplicate it, maybe it's real. So, I think that's a fun show. Destination Truth. That show is not 100% paranormal. They always seem to do two investigations on every episode. One of them is they're searching for a monster, and the second one always seems to be a paranormal investigation. But Joshua Gates is totally my reality TV show husband. If you're out there, Joshua Gates, you're on my top five list, so it's totally acceptable by my husband and everyone. I'm just saying. That show, I'm really sad because the current season was like 4 or 5 episodes or something. Like, it just happened and then it ended. I don't know if it was a mid-season finale or if it was the actual season finale. I just read on Facebook that it's going to be all reruns till October, which sucks. But whatever. Hopefully it'll come back because I like it. Let's see. I'm trying to think of any other paranormal shows that I want. Ooh! Children of the Paranormal, that's also on A&E, same with Paranormal State. It actually has one of the psychics, Chip Coffey, that they used to use. They don't use him anymore on Paranormal State, but he, you know, used to be on almost all the episodes, like in the first season, as one of their, you know, main psychic guys that always came into the homes. And he, you know, tr- tries to help psychic kids. They always have like two kids that are struggling with their psychic abilities because they hear things or blah, blah, blah. And so, you know, he takes them and to some location and they do a little bit of, you know, investigation and, you know, learning how to use their abilities and whatnot. That's a cool show. That's it. That's all I have to say about my paranormal shows. Glee is going to be 90 minutes tonight and it's going to be epic. Epic. I don't know if you've seen, have you seen the video on YouTube? Glee on Fox is the YouTube user, and the video of the Warblers serenading Kurt because he's going back to McKinley in New Directions, and it is an awesome video. It'll bring a tear to your eye. A little tear. It will. And now, to the title of this video. You're probably wondering, what the hell? You have this crazy-ass title about urinals and them being edible, and I'm talking about paranormal stuff. But this is something that I wanted to make a video on this, just talk about this for a while. Because my work used to have this. But now my gym has this. You know, you go to the urinal if you're a guy. If you're not a guy, then you don't go to the urinal. But if you're a guy, you go to the urinal. There's always, you know, a urinal cake or some type of deodorizer thing on the bottom, right? To make it smell not like pee, right? And I'm cool with that. Like, I'm cool with it smelling, you know, pine fresh, minty fresh, whatever. But some of them smell literally tasty. Like you get there and you smell and you're like, I'm hungry now. And that's just not right. Like, the urinal should not smell edible. And worse than just smelling edible, like something that you would want to actually eat. It's wrong. Like, your brain, it can't process that properly. Urinals should not be edible. Have any of you ever gone to a bathroom where you're like that? You're like, this urinal smells good and tasty. Almost like candy or like apple pie. The one at work used to kind of smell like some type of like pie, like apple pie or something. It was weird. Okay, YouTube, that is all I'm going to talk about today. Because I don't think I have anything else to talk about. If you are a fan of the paranormal TV shows, let me know. What paranormal shows do you like to watch? Go ahead and, you know, leave comments. Leave a video response. Thumb me up. And subscribe if you're new. And if you are new, hey! Okay. Till next time, YouTube. Love and bubbles.